Hi there, this is Byron again with the Let's Play of Ultima Underworld. Ah, I see, we're no longer poisoned, but our vitality is, well, 17 out of 35. There's a port of flask belonging to an outcast. We need a port of, a flask of port, but, well, not this one. Because we don't want to annoy the outcasts. So as you probably saw, there are a lot of people here and you can talk with everyone and that takes quite an amount of time. There's another outcast named Gulik. He doesn't have anything important to say, so let's move on. And this here's Hagbard. He is the, you know, the leader of the outcast. Another fish enters the bell. What be thy crime, son of misfortune? It is said I kidnapped a girl. Ah, young girl was this, beauteous but innocent. I never saw her, I am innocent of the charge. Well, how does he handle that? We did see her but hours ago, carried by a troll and pursued by a pack of fools. They fell afoul of the gobs, to be sure. The gobs? Aye, the goblins. There be the greens and the greys, and they are deadly foes. They make our lives more difficult still with their vendettas. What is the nature of their feud? None can say. Their conflict seems to have begun at the time of the great collapse when the civilization of the Underworld fell. We know only that their leaders have sworn never to agree on anything. Is there aught beyond the domain of the goblins? Ah, none who have ventured past the realm of the gobs have returned, but rumor has that there are worse perils below. But I thank thee anyway, farewell. So he doesn't know anything. They are content with staying on the first level, and, you know, dying out of old age because of, well, no. That's not what we're going to do. See, that's what we discovered already. So let's head out here, take a jump, we land into the water, and swim back. So, okay. Let's see whether we can jump over this without getting hurt. We can. There's this guy again. When we talk to him, he asks us whether we visited his group. We can say, yes, we have. Well, I'm glad to hear it. If thou grows weary of thy travel, thou always welcome to stay with us. I thank thee kindly, but my destiny lies elsewhere. Goodbye. So now that we have that red key, we're going... Oh, come on. Move out of the way. We're going back to those two doors that we saw that were locked this year. Going to unlock them. And here we are. The plague reads, plant the seed of the silver sapling and a new sapling will spring forth. In return for this gift of life, thou shalt be granted a new life thyself and this one doth end. That's quite important. It's some sort of a failsafe, you know? As you reach the tree, it withers away, revealing a silver seed. This is the silver seed, and when we use that silver seed, a new tree will grow. And if we die now, the game wouldn't be over, but we will be, like, reborn here where we planted the tree. But we would still lose experience points when we die, so, well, we don't plan on dying, so. And now, I just opened the secret door here. You see a secret door, and I used it, and I went through it. So, this is some sort of secret area. We should save here because we have to do a little jumping, and in case we fall down, I can just reload. So, see, there's a door, a massive door, and that one is locked, and since it's a massive door, you cannot kick it open. A massive door is, like, invulnerable. So we jump over here. See, there's a button. Oh, well. That's why I saved. Back to the button. Okay. Another try. No. What the... Okay. I don't get it. Shouldn't be that easy. That difficult. To jump over here. Maybe I should save here again. And now it works. Use push the button, and the door has opened. Okay. Oh, come on. I don't believe that. Okay, let's swim around here a little. And there we have a rotworm. He is hostile, so we're going to kill him. Put away the sword. See, there's a door. A badly damaged door and it's locked. But like I said, we can, if the door is not massive, we can kick it open, and we're going to do so now. And I used my hand because somehow you can't damage your hand. If I would have attacked the door with a sword, the sword would have taken damage. Oh, come on, I don't believe that. Okay, dead. So, there's the key that would have opened the door, but well, the key was on the wrong side of the door. So, before we try to jump again, let's take a quick look here. So there's another upset asset slug. It's just upset, but nevertheless, let's kill him. Do we have here an orb? Peering into the crystal ball, a vision of a strange world appears. Bizarre creatures float through space. A green path, flanked by a black void on either side, runs off into the distance. Somehow you know that the path leads to Britannia. Well, and that's an important information. The green path leads to Britannia. We should remember that. Okay, that green potion somehow restored our mana. Now we go back. And here we are. Okay. Let's save again. Okay, and jumping over here is quite tricky. No, I don't want to save there. I want to save here. See? Yeah, now it worked. Okay. Now we run around here. What is there? Seeker of the mysterious art, speak Mu'am, the mantra of truth. You know, I told you about the three principles that are truth, love, and courage. And here we get mantras. We can use these mantras to increase our skills. So if we take a look at the map, we see a giant Ankh here. And that actually is the shrine. If you pray at the shrine, well, we could increase our skills. So let's take a look. I'm going to demonstrate that to you. Sumra is the mantra of courage. If we used that, Sumra, we would have increased unarmed and axe. Something else? No. But that would be a waste of, you know, skill points, since it's better to specialize into one category of weapons. Since the amount of experience you can get in this game is limited, so it's better to master a few skills than to dabble in a lot of them. So, well, those kind of combined mantras are not too good. We're not going to use them. Shrine, that's why we saved. So we are going to specialize in sword, and the mantra for sword is Amo. We will find out later in the game. Sword, Amo. Maybe a second time? No, we're not ready to advance. Okay. Oh, let's try something else. Ah, by typing in Fenlo I got the key of truth. Well, you will see later why that makes sense. So, no, don't fall down. Let's save again. And try to jump over here. It worked. Again. So, back through the secret door and to the area we were before. Let's open this door. And prepare for a fight. Incarnation failed. Oh, well. We killed him, yeah, and we're over the 10 minutes mark, so we're going to save here. And I will see you soon in the next video. Thanks for watching, bye!